Thank you very much for giving this opportunity for the first session of this workshop on the financial accounting organized by the IMTCDL. The purpose of this first session is to set the tone of this whole workshop today, and we are starting with this Indian accounting standards. Since I have been the member of the accounting standard board of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, I would like to have the focus on the international financial reporting standards, because we have now decided to converge our Indian accounting standards to IFRS. It is already notified by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, only the date has to be notified. So I will give you the whole background of the subject, and in a limited time, I will try to give you the maximum on the conceptual part of the Indian accounting standards. The first basic question is, what are these standards? What are these accounting standards? And why it is required? What is the purpose of these Indian accounting standards for the purpose of the preparation of the financial statements? So the accounting standards basically are the policy document. And when we say the policy document, it is a rules or it's a norms for a longer duration. It is not that you can change every year or every week or every quarter that you have one accounting policy or the another accounting policy. You have to follow a policy for a longer duration. And in the accounting standards itself, it has been notified, you cannot change once the policy has been adopted, and you can only do change when either the accounting standard has been revised by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, or it has been revised by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, or when the management feels that it would be more appropriate for the better presentation of the financial statement to have the change norms for the accounting policies. This accounting standard basically deals with the five aspects: recognition, measurement, treatment, presentation, and disclosure of accounting events and transactions. When I say recognition, the very basic purpose is when I should recognize revenue in my financial statements. If I take an example, there are two mobile companies, Bharti Airtel and Idea Cellular. Bharti having the maximum customer, they are the post-paid customers. When the Bharti is giving services, they are getting money after raising bill from the customers. And the Idea Cellular, say, is having maximum lot of the customers from the prepaid side. And they are just selling the prepaid card and not giving the services at the time of sale, but it would be provided in the next 1 month or 2 months or 6 months, whatever the validity of the card is. Now, can the both the companies can recognize the revenue at the time of receipt of money? What should be the policy? When I say, in case of Bharti, they have already given the services and then getting the money, it's a simple business transaction. You are giving services, you are delivering the product, and you are getting money, so obviously it is your sale. But in case of prepaid card, I cannot say it is a sale. It is like an advance from the customer. I have just received the money from my customer. The services would be provided in next 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, as and when the customer is utilizing the prepaid card.